So that hymn was written by a man named Maltby Babcock. How'd you like that name? He was a pastor in kind of a rural area, and he always would go out, and he loved to walk out in nature, and he would always tell his wife before he was walking out of the house, "I'm going to go see my father's world." And that's kind of the inspiration for the hymn. And I've always loved that hymn, but I thought, what a perfect hymn with that connection to nature and seeing God at work in the world around you as a great hymn to sing before we have Rick Miller come and share with us this morning. Rick's going to share that the theme for camp this year is devoted. And it's an important theme, but I think it also describes Rick very well. In the years I've known him, most of my life, and the work that he does at the camp to push forward Christian camping and the value that it has at connecting kids to nature in order to connect them to nature's God and the salvation that Christ has and getting them away from the busyness of the world and to a place where they can actually be quiet and hear the voice of God. So I look forward to having Rick share with us this morning, but I believe we're going to begin with a video that has been prepared about camping this summer. It's an honor to have Rick Miller here. Rick is from Brethren Retreat Ministries, Inc. How many of you have been up to Camp Shipshawana, either as a camper or just to visit for different events? Awesome. If you've not been up there, we'd love to see you get up there, and we really want to encourage us to send kids to camp this summer. So Rick, go ahead and come share with us. Kids, junior church. Sorry.
Pastor, I don't want to go home. I know, child. I know. These are the words that I heard a few years ago from a camper during Saturday morning as campers were packing up and getting ready to go home. I was walking along this retreat house sidewalk. The young camper was standing in the doorway facing the pastor. Her head shook, the ponytails went back and forth. The pastor looked at me very solemnly and patted her head. "I know, child. I know." See, this camper was from Indianapolis. She lived on Capitol Street. If you're not familiar with Capitol Street, it's not a very nice place. It's got cluttered streets, distressed housing, and frequent violence. Many times we encounter campers that have such a positive experience at Camp Shipshawana that they simply wish they didn't have to go home. Camp offers a safe community that breaks the routines of life. There's tasty food, lots of it, five times a day. There's new and exciting activities, laughter, fun, adventure. Then there are quiet moments filled with nuggets of truth from Bible lessons, praises, worship songs, and testimonies. Often our six generations of campers will say, I have my lifelong friendships formed during Camp Shipshawana. And it's fun to watch them interact on Facebook. Good morning, I'm Rick Miller, also known as the Camp Guide. I've served as the Executive Director at the Brethren Retreat since May 1995. I'm getting ready to start my 29th summer. I've seen many changes in youth culture. Our society has changed drastically since 1995. Technology places information at our scrolling thumbs more than ever before. I learned the Dewey Decimal System. You guys remember that? As a youth, we used to compare how many states we'd been to. Now the youth talk about how many different countries they've been to. Farther, faster, frequent, yes. We're still fragmented, frustrated, and many times friendless. In January 2022, I was here. I shared with you about relationships, a concept that was coined as the lonely crowd, if you might recall. I shared the value and the opportunity for deep, intimate relationships, especially within the church body. I shared the messiness of relationships that are expensive financially, costly, time-consuming, and can create serious vulnerabilities. We're coming out of the COVID fall. Can you feel it? Our relationships are still a little bit disconnected in this new season, but we must not be divided. We must not be divided. Did you know that our pastors are exhausted, many frustrated, and leaving the ministry the past 3 years? Did you know that church attendance is still 40% below what it was pre-COVID? That adds to the frustration and exhaustion of our pastors. I know they take it personal. I feel it too. Did you know more people are questioning the value of their faith and feel less committed to a body of believers since COVID? Did you know that people are still very hungry for truth and they're seeking answers more now than ever? As the scripture said on Acts 2, and I'll read that again for you, the early church was very devoted to one another. Therefore, let all Israel be assured of this. God has made this Jesus, whom you crucified, Lord and Messiah. Amen.
Amen.
Let me read it again. Therefore, let all Israel be assured of this. God has made this Jesus, whom you crucified, both Lord and Messiah. When the people heard this, they were cut to their heart, cut to the heart, wrenched with pain, gruesome. To get to the heart, you're cutting through bone. And they said to Peter and the other apostles, brothers, what should we do? Peter replied, repent, turn around, be baptized, every one of you in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of your sins. And you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. The promise is for you and all your children. For the Lord, our God, will call. With many other words, he warned them and pleaded with them. Save yourselves from this corrupt generation. Those who accepted this message were baptized. There was about 3,000 of them that day. What a revival, huh? They devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and to fellowship, to breaking of bread and prayer. Everyone was filled with awe at the many things that they seen and were performed by the apostles. All the believers were together and had everything in common. In the main theme verse that we have for the summer, verse 42, there's four aspects. Teaching, learning the scriptures, and admonishing one another, holding each other accountable to those scriptures. Teaching, learning, and holding each other accountable. One of the things I have seen is a lack of knowledge in the scriptures. I noticed it soon after the two tents that our campers didn't understand the basic stories. Flood? What big flood are you talking about? And in 2018, I started to feel this strange sense that our summer staff didn't have a grasp of the scriptures. And then through many different Zoom meetings and things the last 2 years, I'm hearing other camp directors say the same thing. We have young people that don't know the scriptures. Fellowship, second aspect. Gathering together in person to eat. Love it. To serve one another, to share one another. We gather together, fellowship dinners, Bible studies, going to serve other people that need help, mission trips, hospital visits. The third aspect, celebrate. I love celebrations. I love recognizing those moments in a life journey. Significance as we walk along the daily path of life together as a body, celebrating birthdays. I think the mama enjoyed that happy birthday more than the child. Special moments. As well as remembering the sacrifice that Jesus had for each one of us, and those walking out in the streets, hanging out in the homes nearby, for our sins. We're in that season where we're celebrating that event. And then the fourth aspect, prayer. The Bible has five aspects, or five types of prayers. Requesting on our behalf, giving thanksgiving for our blessings, adoration, exalting God and Jesus for their love, their grace, their mercy, the things they've done for us, confession of our sins. We get dirty as we walk this spiritual journey. And intercession, the devotion to be able to pray for those that are ill, wandering, or in need of our support on their behalf. So what do you see in these four aspects? Got the four icons up there: teaching, gathering, celebrating, prayer. What do you see? Those four aspects are community. Those four aspects are relationships. Those four aspects are devotion. We're made to be in relationship. I'll say it again. Everywhere I go, conversations that I'm in with pastor leaders and church leaders, it all comes down to one thing. It's relationship. Relationships this way, and relationships this way. One another, and with our spiritual father. It's not about a fancy building or a fancy program or a beautiful brochure. It's the relationships. One person talking to another and saying, come with me. I have something to share with you. TV Church is not filling these needs. But TV Church is safe, it's convenient, and it's available. Are you devoted? as verse 40 says, Peter warned and pleaded, and you know the personality of Peter, big, tough, robust guy, and if he's warning and he's pleading, he's in your face. And he was telling them with many words. He was relentless. He didn't quit. Save yourselves. Save yourselves from this corrupt generation. Has anything changed in 1900 years or so? Save your friends. Save your family. What are the first priorities in your life? Where do you spend your time? Where do you spend your money? There are many people who want to enter a church building today. They just won't walk in off the street. There's too many false notions about Christians, who they are and what they do. Some people don't even, church people don't even like to use the term Christian anymore. They'll use the term Christ follower. I don't want to be a Christian, I want to be a Christ follower. Same thing, but it's the connotation. If people knew that we have all the answers, it's in that book called the Bible. Every answer to life's ills, the corrupt generation, is in that book. And yet, we have a generation of leaders coming up that don't know the book very well. Let's begin to share the book. Let's begin to teach and admonish and gather and celebrate and pray. As a high school camper, a high school camper walked across the campus on a registration Sunday. He was loud and obnoxious. Had his hat turned sideways, kind of walking with a strut. And I thought, oh boy, we got our hands full this week. By Tuesday, this young man was standing in front of the fire with the other counselors, and he was leading songs. His hat was straight. He was solemn, worshipful. Wednesday. Thursday, Friday afternoon, the hat goes back, the strut comes back, loud and obnoxious. He was getting ready to go home. He had to protect himself. He had to be cool back home. But for 72 hours at Camp Shipshawana, that young man enjoyed community and relaxed. And we've seen who he was. Brethren Retreat at Shipshawana Lake, we want to be your partner in ministry. Would you utilize us? Our campus is beautiful. Our outdoor sanctuary is peaceful. Our camps and our retreats are effective. 13% of our campers will say yes to Jesus. Nearly 70% of every camper will make a spiritual decision. Our counselors many times become the church leaders. Leadership development is strong at camp. Past guests will frequently come back and they'll just walk the grounds, going through a really tough time. Can I just walk? This is where I felt safe. Camp provides spiritual formation. Camp prepares great food, fun, fellowship. Camp builds relationships for life and eternity. Camp creates quiet moments to reflect and pray. Camp offers a safe community to build relationships. Utilize the Brethren Retreat at Shipshawana Lake. Please volunteer regularly. In the bulletin, I mentioned about the mother-daughter. Jeff made reference about coming up to volunteer. I can't be there. I've got a graduation for my youngest daughter. And so, men, it's a mother-daughter event. Can you come up and help? We could use men as well. Attend our retreats. We have, I gave you a schedule on the sheet. There's some laying at each corner of the entrances. We have something going on almost every month, and bring your friends up. It's an informal place to build a relationship before they might come into this building. Once they have fun and community there, say, I have another community I'd like to introduce you to. Send your youth to camp, Shipshawana. Passionately be devoted to making sure that families choose a camp experience as a priority in their household this summer. Recently struggled to launch a retreat. Made over 50 phone calls. 40 of them that I connected with, they had other activities they couldn't come. I didn't see it as activities. I seen it as different priorities. That cut to my heart. Camp is filled with fun. Camp makes faith real. Camp promotes discipleship. Camp changes lives. This year's snow camp concluded. I approached a camper parent who was standing in the retreat house lobby. She had this bewildered, dumbfounded look on her face as she was leaning against the table with her arms folded, facing the water cooler and the bathroom doors on either side. I said, is everything okay? Her response shocked me, but only for a brief moment. See, the parent said to me, my child's barricaded themselves in the bathroom. He doesn't want to go home. She instructed me that the counselor was in the bathroom with him. Consoling her child. You see, this foster child had a lot of trouble making friends. He's not well accepted by the other students at school. The teachers had labeled him a behavior problem. He'd been bounced around from home to home in his 12 brief years. He was in the process of being adopted by the foster mom. For that one brief weekend, a Friday night, a Saturday, and a Sunday morning, he found community. And he didn't want to leave it. There's more to the story. The counselor was in the bathroom with him. He had a similar background. Wasn't a foster child, but his mom bumped him around, him and his brother, from hotel room to hotel room. They never had the same address each year of camp because they never knew where they were going to be living. Sometimes it was a car or a hotel because they got evicted. But this counselor had the opportunity to nurture the young camper from his own experiences. As I debriefed with the counselor later, he said, whoa, man, like that was really weird. This counselor has long hair. He loves rock and roll. Takes on this funny little surfer dude attitude, but he's got an open heart for Jesus. It's just not nurtured every single day. As we reflected together, I shared the value that that moment that he was able to build a relationship with this camper because of his difficult life experiences. Who better to understand a struggling young life than a friend, a mentor, a counselor, devoted to serving God? Friends at New Paris First Brother, you are special to me because this is home. We're getting ready to launch summer. We've got some really cool events. We're still recruiting summer staff, especially need male staff, boys. Don't let our beds be empty this summer. Don't let our beds be empty. Embrace a child. Impact a family. Be devoted.
Amen. Why don't we pray, and then we'll have the worship team come up, and we'll close in our two worship songs. But God, we thank you for the ministry of the Brethren Tree Center. Father, I want to pray for Rick and for Tracy. I want to pray, Father, for the staff that you will bring. We pray that there will be the staff needed, Father. I know that the young men are especially needed right now. I pray that you would put in the hearts of those counselors to come and invest in the lives. And that, Father, through that, that they would hear the call of God to minister and to serve. Not just during the summer, but over their entire lives to serve you. Father, I want to pray for that foster kid that's being adopted. I pray that he's able to come back this summer. But I pray that he's able to find community at home as well, and I pray for his young life. Father, we want to pray for all of the other kids, Father, that are going to camp this summer, that you would prepare the way for them. That you would impact them with their life-changing gospel message of Jesus Christ. That they would be saved from a sinful and corrupt generation, Father. And all of us have been a part of that generation before we put our faith in Christ. And we were in spiritual darkness, so now we are in the light. And we pray, Father, that that would be the case for the students that come this summer. Lord, we ask that for our own congregation that we would accept the challenge of sending not just the kids that we have here that attend on a Sunday morning. We know that there's not many in our church right now. But Lord, we know neighbor kids. We have grandkids, great-grandkids, nieces, nephews that can hear the gospel and grow in their faith. With a week away at the camp, Lord, that you would put it on our hearts to not just send them, but provide the way for them to go so that cost is not an issue, as we've made that a priority at our church the last several years. Father, we pray for the ministry of the Brethren Retreat, that this would be a year where we are devoted to you, and that devotion would show in the way that we send kids, send volunteers, send workers, Father, for the kingdom. We thank you that Rick could be here today, and we pray that we have been encouraged, Lord, by his message, and we pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. I would invite you to stand. We're going to sing, Our God is Greater.
Water you turned into wine, open the eyes of the blind, there's no one like you, none like you. Into the darkness you shine, out of the ashes we rise, there's no no one like you. None like you. Our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God, our God. Into the darkness you shine. Out of the ashes we rise. No one like you. None like you. Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer. Awesome in power. Our God. Our God. Sing that again. Our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God, our God. And if our God is for us, then he could ever stop us. And if our God is with us, then what can stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand against? What can stand against? Sing, our God is greater.
The God that knows all things, things that we can't even imagine, things that, you know, David said that such knowledge is too wonderful for me. But we also have a God that not only knows all things, but is always with us in the midst of all the ups and downs in life. And we can look back over our life and see how God has been faithful. And so when sometimes we're here and we can raise our hands and praise God because we feel the joy of the Lord, and there's other times when we're in the midst of a storm and we have to choose. Worship becomes harder because it's a choice, not a natural reaction. And so we want to close this morning by singing a song called Praise You in the Storm. I was sure by now you would have reached down, wiped dark tears away, stepped in and saved the day. But once again, I say amen, and it's still raining. As thunder rolls, hear the air whisper through the wind, I am with you. As the mercy calls, raise my hands, praise the God who gives, takes away. And I praise you in this storm.
strength is almost gone. How can I carry on if I can't find you? Dazzled on the rules, I barely hear a whisper through me. I am with you. Dazzled birds fall, raise my hands, pray to God who gives. Takes away.
Is going to come to pass. And our hope is in the return of Jesus Christ. It is coming. Amen. He is returning. We don't know when, but he is returning, and that gives us assurance, and that gives us meaning and the ability to carry on, Father. So, Father, as we go through storms this week, we ask that that hope would be an anchor for us. Not an anchor that holds us down, but an anchor that keeps us tethered to the truth and tethered to our faith. And that we'd be able to share that hope, not the wish, but we would share the assurance with others who wonder why we can keep going in troubled times. May we be encouraged this morning. May we encourage one another, even as we leave this place, Father. Encourage our hearts in Christ. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you for coming this morning. We'll see you next Sunday. Have a blessed week. Talk to Rick before you leave.